key points in the wealth sharing and annex, particularly on the what he was saying was a source of energy, that the government was asking for a 50-50 percentage as opposed to what was earlier agreed upon, which was a 75-25 sharing.
Well, we know that in negotiations we do have to have compromises. The important thing is that what we are trying to do is to come up with a very good fiscal arrangement for the Bank Samoro. And that will, if we look at the offer that the government is making, you will find that altogether, this will really enable the Bank Samoro government that will be created by the Bank Samoro Basic Law to have a lot of resources that they can use for the benefit of their own constituencies. So that is the kind of thing that we have. That's the kind of package that we have put together, and we are still working on the different elements. Sometimes it seems that we get lost in the trees and fail to see the whole forest. So every now and then we do stop and pause and take a look at the forest again so that we can appreciate every little detail that we're trying to put together in the text and see how it all fits in.
Okay, I just want to clarify something. The vice chair specifically mentioned just the source of energy where the government is asking for a 50-50 sharing. But, of course, we're talking about sharing of a lot of other sources of possible funding or revenues or budget for the Bank Samoro. In general, would it still have that... Professor, can you hear me? Professor?
Yes.
Okay.
Engineer.
Yes, okay.
What was the question?
Okay, the vice chair specifically mentioned just the source of energy, and the government was asking for a 50-50 sharing. Now I want to know, that, of course, there are still a lot of other points where or funds or budget that the government and the MILF or the Bank Samoro can have a sharing agreement, but in general, will it still have a 75-25 sharing in favor of the MILF Bank Samoro?
So that's the sticky issue about the energy resources. I think with regards to other sources of revenue, including national taxes and other natural resources, more or less we have come to terms. The irony here is that we have been talking about something that isn't there yet. So to that effect, this is something that is very very uncertain in fact as to what actual revenues will be enjoyed in the future. But what I can say is that government offer is fair, it's very good, it's much better than what other autonomous regions or even federal states are enjoying in other countries. So that's the kind of appreciation that we hope that the MILF will understand. The perspective on the president on this is that maybe the Bank Samoro could consider this as their, if indeed we will be able to generate these energy resources from the Bank Samoro territorial jurisdiction, then certainly they can consider it the share of national government as their contribution to nation, to the whole country.
You mentioned that you want to continue with the talks today. Has the other side committed to being part of the talks for today, ma'am?
Well, that is our understanding. As far as government is concerned, we are committed to the process. We are ready to go into the all the details of the text that we are trying to put together. We come in the spirit of give and take. Flexibility is something that both sides need right now.
And if the MILF does not agree to go back to the table today, ma'am, what would be the government's move?
I think both of us want to finish these annexes as soon as possible, so it will be unfortunate if further delay could happen. there are matters that can be settled, and if we do find difficulty in settling other matters, at least we can come to terms with the others and see how we can move forward with items that still find no resolution as of today.
So you can do that. You can set aside the talks on wealth sharing or wealth sharing annex for the meantime and proceed with the other issues that can be agreed upon. Is that the plan, ma'am?
That wasn't very clear, but the plan now is to see how far we can go in terms of finding common text and see what new language we can come up with, what other compromises can be put on the table and considered by the other party. I think that's the whole spirit of negotiation or even the spirit of dialogue, is that you are able to understand each other's concern and try to find ways and means to meet both concerns.
Okay, on the normalization annex, I understand that the technical working groups have signed already a joint report. Does that mean this is a good chance of being signed by formally signed by both panels soon as well?
Well, no. It's still a working report,
okay,
meaning that they have put together elements that they are discussing and that are still subject to future discussion.
Okay, so no signing of that yet. What was signed was the technical reports, the technical working groups reports.
No. Only a report to be submitted by the working group to the panels.
Okay, Professor Miriam Ferrer, the Philippine government's chief negotiator, thank you very much, ma'am, for talking to us this morning. More news. Three suspected members.